Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, June 17th, 2008. In the pre-market this morning, we've got U.S. Stock market futures up across the board. Look for a lot of volatility in these futures before the market opens. We've got economic numbers coming out. We've got Goldman Sachs coming out. So look for a lot of volatility. We've got both crude oil and gold down in the pre-market this morning. So look for some pressure on the TSX at the open at 9:30. Now, the big news story on Monday was the dramatic reversal in crude oil, made a new high on Monday, and actually closed lower on the day. That's a big reversal day. Now, we're looking for follow-through on Tuesday. We're down $1.50 to $2 in the pre-market, so we don't know how that's going to hold. We've got some chart support in, we've got an open gap just below where the trading range we've been in the last week or so. That may act as support. Then we've got support at 125. If that does not hold, then the next area of support is down at the 112.50 area. Now, looking at the daily flypaper channel, we've got flypaper support in the 112-120 area. So as long as crude oil holds in that or above it, then we know that this bull market is intact. If it starts closing below 112, then we know we've probably got some problems in the crude oil market and some sort of shift in the dynamics of that market. Now, the other story this week, of course, is the U.S. financial stocks, and Goldman Sachs is coming out with numbers today. It's been up the last 3 days in a row, so, you know, this might be the situation where people buy the rumor, sell the news. Resistance is at 187.50. If that does not hold, then look for a move up to $200 for Goldman Sachs. Now, we talked about the fact that the market loves this stock, does not necessarily love JP Morgan. Hit resistance yesterday at 40.63. That will probably hold. If that does not hold, look for a move up to the 42.19 area for JP Morgan. Another stock the market doesn't like right now is Lehman Brothers. Lehman Brothers should find resistance at 31.25. If that is can be broken, then look for a move up to ultimately 37.50 for this stock. And Citibank, we're looking for resistance at 21.88. You know, I am still looking for Citibank to head down towards the $15 area before this down move in the U.S. financial market is over. Looking at some Canadian financial stocks, Bank of Montreal, if you can get its act together, 46.88 should be the high for the Bank of Montreal. We saw CIBC hit its resistance target at 65.63 yesterday. That's probably all for CIBC. And looking at the Royal Bank hit $50 yesterday, and that's probably the high for the Royal Bank. You know, just to take a look at this. We've got a lot of resistance between 50 and 51.56 for the Royal Bank. Note it made a high back here, and then it recently made a lower high, and we expect it to make another lower high over here. Now, the opposite of crude oil going up, of course, crude oil going down, where can we profit? I think the airline stocks are an opportunity. One of the cheapest airline stocks out there is JetBlue, and I'm looking to buy some JetBlue. This is a stock that I play on a regular basis. You know, looking at what the pros and what the public do, you know, it's pretty nice to watch this stock. And to just play it when the pros are taking control, or shorting it when the public takes control. Right now, the public is still in control, waiting for this to turn around, but nothing wrong with buying some shares here to get the trade started. We're down at the bottom of the panic zone, of course. There's a huge pressure zone down there. You know, anytime that you see a pressure zone, this is basically a multiple pressure zone, and the reason for that is that we've missed some cycles here. You know, this stock was going down, going up, going down, going up, and then, you know, it just failed right at this point here is where the cycle failed. And so we're waiting for that cycle to get back in queue, get back on a regular basis. And what we're thinking could happen is that we could move up to the $5 area from here once the uptrend gets started. So 391, we're clustering around that right now. 469 is the next mathematical target to the upside, and then 547. The flypaper channel is telling us that we're going to have a difficult time getting there, but I don't see any problem getting up to at least the 469 area for this particular stock. Right now, looking at the daily right side chart, we've got, you know, the early warning signal down here. We don't have anything else blue. Looking for a daily close above 410 would give us a new buy signal. I'm going to be buying some stock this week just on a spec without a buy signal and without the pros taking control. I'm going to buy about a 25% position, and then I'm going to add to it if and when this stock starts to move up. But that's just an example of one of the many plays in the airline sector. If you've got a favorite airline stock, it's very possible that any move down in oil stocks will put a boost into these beaten down airline stocks. Now, looking at the 60-minute charts for the major indexes, for the TSX, we were looking for it to get caught here. It moved up, couldn't get up to the previous high, but certainly got up to major resistance at 15,000 and then stopped on a dime. So we're looking for, if we see commodities sell off on Tuesday, of course, that's probably going to put pressure on the TSX. And looking at what the pros are doing, again, this is a 60-minute chart, but we're certainly up to where the same area where the TSX peaked previously. And so on Tuesday, we're going to need to see an hourly close below 14,850 to give us a new intraday sell signal for the TSX. Looking at the S&P 500, was not able to get up to the targets we had on Monday. We're looking for an hourly close below 1352 to tell us that this current intraday uptrend for the S&P 500 is over. And look at the NASDAQ, got right up to our targets that we set yesterday morning. Obviously, we're still projecting higher if it can get above resistance on Tuesday. On the downside, looking over our shoulder, we need an hourly close below 2450 on Tuesday to tell us that this current intraday uptrend for the NASDAQ is over. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Look for a lot of volatility in the futures before the market opens at 9:30, and let's see what happens to those financial stocks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.